Hello and welcome to another episode of my Working with Evernote series. My name is Carl Pullein and this week it's all about creating a journal using Evernote. Now this is a viewer request. I was asked how would I create a daily journal using Evernote, and Evernote can do a fantastic job with creating and using a journal. Now, before we go any further, I would just like to say, if you do get any value from this video, then please help me by clicking on that like button below. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet and you want to get all the latest tips, tricks, and news on using Evernote, then please subscribe to my channel. Okay, let me take you into my Evernote demo account now, and I will show you how I would create a journal using Evernote. Okay, now the first thing you're going to need to do is create yourself a journal template. Now, in this case, what I've done is I've taken the template I use in day one. Now, I actually use the day one journaling app. I don't use Evernote for this. This is just purely how I would do it if I was doing it in Evernote. So I don't want to cause any confusion with anyone out there. I actually use day one, which is a specific journaling app, for reasons that I pointed out in the video I did on day one. But this is how I would do it if I was creating a journal in Evernote. So the first thing is I would create a template. Now you can create here whatever you want. So this is just a direct copy of what I actually have in my real journal. So what will I accomplish today? Now this is where I usually put my two objectives. And the way I would do this is I would create a checklist there and a checklist there. So that's how I would do that. So I can just then add in my two objectives for the day. What do I need to improve? I would put that one as a bullet point. And what did I learn today? Again, I would do that as a bullet point. Because when you're writing a journal, what I'm wanting to do is those little bits are just like lists. These are the things that I can monitor. Then down here, I've got what exercise. So I've got my morning routine, by the way, here, and that's just a regular checklist. So as I do that, I can just check off these as I take them. So that's my morning routine, if you like, or things that I want to develop, things that I want to become habitual, turn into a habit. And then we've got my evening routines as well, because I'm always forgetting to drink apple cider vinegar with my dinner and take my vitamin pills. And this is like a check. Did I walk my 10,000 steps for the day? Now, that's something I added because of the lockdown and because of the pandemic. I wasn't moving how I wanted to move, and that was causing a bit of a problem. And then here I've got what exercise did I do today, because that's a way of monitoring my exercise. Now down here is where you can add like your own notes. So I would add in notes like how the day went and so on and so forth. And I would also probably drag in a picture or something like that in here if you're trying to keep a picture a day or whatever from what you did. So once you've set that up, the next thing to do before you do anything else, I'm using the web here, but it works pretty much the same way. If you go up to the three dots here, more actions, and go down to the thing where it says save as template. So I'm going to click that and I'm going to save that as journal template. Now, what I will probably do is I would add a date here, a year, because my templates change on a year to year basis. So I'm going to save that. So that's now saved in my template folder. And we'll come back to that in a moment. So that's how we've set that up. Now, what we want to do is now go to our notebooks, and I've saved time here. What I've done is I've created a stack. So I've got a stack here with the number 05 journal and 2021, because what you're going to be doing is you're not just going to journal for 1 year. You're going to be journaling for many years, hopefully. So you want to be denoting what this year, what this particular journal refers to. And inside that stack, I've created a notebook for each of the months. Now I stopped at October because I wanted to show you how to create the notebook inside the stack. So if you go to the stack here and go to the three dots at the side, you'll get create notebook in journal. So I'm going to do that. And I'm going to go, this one is now, we're on to 11. So I'm going to go November 2021. Now the reason I'm putting the year is, again, when you're thinking ahead for search, because over a period of, say, 5 years, you've got 5 years, five Novembers. So if you're looking for a specific date, you do want to make know how you're going to find that right year. And then we go back in there and I'll create December's. So December is 12 and December 2021. And that's it. So now I have my 12 months. Now, I would recommend that you do spend a little bit of time and set that up right now, because you don't want to be doing this at the end of the month. You just want to get this set up straight away. So let's go open up the January template. So I've opened up the January notebook. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to create, add the plus. I'm just going to say create new note, and I can type in the date. So I'm going to type in the date, and the date is 22nd of January as I'm recording this. Now I'm going to go to my templates here, and you'll see that I've got my journal template. So I'm going to click on that, and that will bring in, all being well, that will bring in, it didn't. Let's try that again. There we go. Click on that, and that brings in my template. So my template is there, and I've set the date up. And that's it. That's really all you have to do. And then you can just go in, and now you've got your journal for today is now in there. So let's say that I've done that. That's today, and that's all done. That's great. That's fantastic. Here, by the way, I would probably put a headline for the day, because that way you don't have the same writing up here. So I just, like in here, I would just put a headline. So today was the day I recorded a summary of the day, if you like. Today was the day I recorded my YouTube videos. And oh dear, we are having all sorts of fun today. This is the problem I find using the web. It was the day I recorded my YouTube videos. There we go. And I'll just hit return. That will come into here eventually. It's because it's on the web and it's just not updating. But if you're using the app version, you'll probably find that it updates in real time. And that's just there. There you go. It's now come in. So that's one way of just giving that a little bit of uniqueness right there. Now, if I have a look in my images, maybe I've got an image that I can use right here. I've been doing a little bit of, let's have a look. As a, okay, I found a quote here. Let's say I drop this quote that I got here, which I love this quote. So that's been dropped in. So you can just drop an image in. And that's come in. So best advice from Dad. You believed in Santa for 8 years. You can believe in yourself for 10 seconds. So there, what will happen is this will actually eventually show up on the side here when it updates. But there's another thing that you can do. You can actually just add in your images. So there's a lot of things that you can add in here and you can just play around. But that's basically, as you see, it's come in right now. So what I've got is you'll see like an image at the side of the headline here. So let's go back into, I'm still in January, so I can just hit plus. And I can say we'll put the 23rd of January 2021. And again, I'm going to go to my templates. There it is. Click that. And that comes straight in. And again, today is Saturday. And I have a workshop to do, which I do. I am presenting a workshop tonight. Or tomorrow morning. So there's my little headline for the day, and then I can do whatever I want from there. And so what you'll notice is that these notes are coming in with the oldest one at the bottom and the newest one at the top. You can now go into here and you can change these. You can actually move these around. So date created, or you can have date updated. So I'm going to change that to date created. And I'm going to, let's see if we can just change, we can't change the order. I'm surprised at that. I thought we could change the order upside down, but there we go. Or maybe we can do it by title. There we go. If you do it by title, because you're actually putting the dates in, then you're going to do it that way. But it's up to you how you want that to show. But there is a way of playing around with the sort feature in there. So there you go. That's how I would create a journal inside Evernote. So let's just go refresh that a little bit. So go back to the notebook stack here. What I'm going to do is I created, as you can see, I've got my notebooks here. By the way, if you are struggling to get the numbers to come up, because I did in a previous episode, one of the things that you can do is go to the sort function here and turn off group by type. If I click group by type, it will put the stacks at the top and then the notebooks underneath. And then you, obviously, as you can see here, my numbers are out of sync. Turn off group by type and it will do it by the numbers. So this puts them all in the right order that I want. So create a stack, and inside the stack, you want to put the actual dates, the months. And I would do again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so make sure it stays in the right order. And also here, make sure you put the year, because hopefully you're going to be journaling for many, many years and you want to be able to get to that very quickly. And then for the note itself, what you want to do is to create it as a template. So there you go. Hopefully that has given you some ideas about how you can create your own journal. Remember, this is for you. This is your journal. This is just the way I would do it. You may have a different way that you prefer, but I just wanted to put this out there to give you some ideas about how you want to, or how you may want to create a journal in your very own Todoist, Evernote. So there you go. Thank you very much for watching this episode. And it just remains for me now to wish you all a very, very productive week. Hello, thank you very much for watching my videos. Now I have something exciting to tell you about. Recently, I have developed a brand new time management system. It's a system designed to manage your time in the 21st century. The world has changed a lot over the last 20 years. In fact, it's actually changed a lot this year. And what we need now is a system, a time management system that is very easy to use, easy to maintain, so that you can spend more of your time doing the work. And that's what the time sector system is all about. It's going to change your whole belief system about the way a time management system should work, because this focuses on when you are going to do the task. And let's be honest, it doesn't matter how motivated, inspired, or how urgent something is. If you don't have time to do it, it is never going to get done. And that's what this system is built around, getting your work done, so you can spend more of your time doing the things that you want to do. I hope you join me in this course. The full details of the course are in the show notes below, so please join me, and thank you very much for watching this brief video.